prop design, and my daughter's with Crescent City Cosplay. We're professional cosplayers. We go to cons and compete, and we've done, luckily, pretty well. We've got awards from Dragon Con, from Mecha Con. Dragon Con brings in over 75,000 people in Atlanta. It's a huge cosplay venue. It's one of the more difficult ones to compete in, because you get a lot of different types of people there, but it's everyone there is amazing, and how well they do their work. It's just everybody pays a lot of attention to their detail. They're really good actors. You meet a lot of really fun people. We've got some backstage video of Dragon Con too. But at Dragon, we've won Best of Show, overall Best of Show at the Masquerade. We've won Best of Masters Class, Best Bioshock, which was a strange award. At MechaCon, we've won, she's won Best Team Walk-On. She's also won Best Team Walk-On at Dragon. And I won Best Walk-On for our Bioshock Big Daddy costume, which we did once there. So yeah, we've done a few things in over the last just 5 years and done that. So we've been real, real lucky. There's been some really hard competition and really talented people. And what's great about competing in cosplay is you meet all these people behind the stage and you can share information and become friends and run into them every year. And it's just a lot of fun. Have any of y'all competed before? Yeah, where have you competed? That's awesome though, yeah. What did you compete as in MechaCon?
I was Big Bad this year.
Oh, okay, yeah, sweet. Did you do well? Was it fun for you?
It was fun, I like competing.
I love MechaCon. MechaCon's our best local con. We absolutely adore it, you know, because we're from here too. We're from Prairieville, actually. So I just tell you some of the things we've learned doing this stuff. I mean, we're not, by any stretch of the imagination, as experienced as a lot of other people, but we have come across some things that help. And what's worked for us. Start with the beginning. Before you do any kind of competition, scope it out. If you can get to the convention earlier, a day or two before the actual competition, go there, look at the stage, find out where all the rails are, how wide the stairs are. If you've got a big cosplay, do you have to turn sideways to get on the stage? Are there going to be people there to help you get on the stage? Handlers, have a good handler while you're there, you know, to have all your things ready. You know, you bring tools, you bring parts, so that when things break, you have things to actually replace them with. You know, so that way, because you want to be completely reliable and ready when you get on stage. You don't want swords falling off. You don't want, you know, your wings to fall off. You know, whatever. You know, you want to make sure you're reliable and straight. Because while you're up there, I mean, while you're waiting, usually you'll spend almost half the day when you're in competition. Just waiting for the thing to start. And while you're back there, you're in the dark. Other people are big cosplays and they're running into you too. And so you're gonna be bumping into things and things are gonna fall off. You're gonna have issues. So be prepared for that. Have tools available, have materials, you know, nuts and bolts and screws and glue, you know, just so that when things fall off, you can fix them real quick. Because you're not gonna have a second chance the day of. So scope it out, make sure it works well. That's the day of, okay? But before that, after you've got your cosplay ready, a lot of people will work until the day of the competition and do no rehearsal whatsoever. I mean, you'll like just show up and like, oh, okay, what do I have to do? I gotta walk and turn and go. But you have nothing worked out. And so always know, like, is it a T-shaped stage? Is it a straight horizontal stage? Am I coming in from the right, from the left? And so that way when you're there, it's clear in your mind, I've already done this, I've already walked it at my house, and I know I gotta get this far, it's gonna take me this long to go from here to here. I'm gonna do this motion, I'm gonna do this act with my weapons. Work out everything you're gonna do beforehand, don't wing it. I mean, it looks bad. When you go on stage and you've got no prep set up, and you've never rehearsed or done it even in front of a friend, and you're out there, you're just like, you know, I mean, it looks really unprofessional, and it doesn't come across, and it doesn't impress the judges. But if you're there really prepared, and you know exactly where you're supposed to be, where your key points are, it looks a lot better. So yeah, rehearsals and practice and run-throughs. We try to do at least one complete, total run-through, full costume, full effects, full sound, full everything, in front of at least two or three friends, and so they can critique it and tell us, oh, well, you look kind of wooden doing that, or you looked, you missed your cue, your sound cue was wrong, you know. And so that way you can get at least one good run through down minimum. The other thing a lot of people run into is stage fright. stage fright, you're backstage, and yeah, you got anxiety building, and it builds and it builds and it builds, because you're backstage for like an hour and a half to 2 hours sometimes before the thing even starts, and it's like, it can really make you nervous. But the best thing to think about stage fright is a lot of people say, imagine the audience naked or whatever like that, but it's even better to just imagine they're not even there, okay? Because when you're on stage, you would think you're gonna see thousands of eyeballs looking at you, and they're gonna be judging every little detail on your costume and how well you're acting, and they're gonna be, no. When you're on stage, there's these freaking lights on your face, you can't see anybody. I mean, you might as well be in your living room. You're not gonna be afraid of people when you're up there. It's literally, you get up there and you just do your thing, man. I mean, just focus on being your character, focus on being the person you're trying to portray, and get it done, you know? That's always worked for me, you know, because like I'll be nervous as heck. That what I get nervous about isn't so much the people watching me as I am the actual, you know, the things we've set up. You know, is she gonna remember her lines? Is she gonna remember to do the steps right? You know, I'm more worried about the actual presentation. That's where your focus should be. Don't worry about, am I gonna look stupid? You know, just think about it as, is this gonna actually happen? You know, make it work. Because when things fall apart on stage, that's like the worst thing for me. A battery runs dead or something like that. That happened to Dragon this year. These folks did an amazing job putting together this big road rage setup. Mad Max?
Mad Max, like Mario Kart.
Yeah, Mad Max Mario Kart. I mean, they made like six of them, and the kids were all dressed up beautifully. They looked really, really good. And they all get on stage, and the first car in the front dies. You know, apparently they didn't do the battery right. They didn't check it the night before, and it just died right in the middle of the stage, and it just kind of scooted like that all the way across the stage. And literally, that probably killed their presentation. Because I mean, they would have won probably Children's Division easily. You know, and yeah, but because of that one little thing, it kind of, everybody was laughing, and it just completely destroyed the mood. And so again, you know, as I'm saying, reliability rehearsals, making sure you got it nailed down, everything's gonna work. Very, very important. And in fact, the other thing about worrying about the audience, the only people you should be worried about on stage are the judges. The judges are going to be in front, and they're going to be the ones that are going to tell you if you've done a good job or not, or how you've reacted against the other folks. And so if you do make eye contact with anyone, the judges are who you want to look at. You want to look at them individually, you know, as you're doing your thing. That's where your eye should be, is the judges panel. Don't look off into the audience, don't look off to the side. Try not to ever turn your back to the audience either. Like if you're walking off stage, try to walk at a three quarter like this. If you turn your back, it always looks bad. Unless you have something you want to show that's on your back. If you have big wings or something like that, you can do a spin, of course. You know, but when you're walking on and off stage, don't turn around so that you're not facing anyone. You know, always kind of do that. You know, you want to be always facing the front. Yeah, and of course, even if you are still afraid of people with stage fright, 99% of these people are never going to see you again. I mean, they're not gonna post a YouTube video of you somewhere. You know,
everybody backstage has just as much stage fright too.
Yeah, they do too. And you help each other backstage. That's what's so much fun. Backstage is I'll go ahead and show you the video real quick of what backstage is like. They come back and we have friendly competition with each other. You know, it's like, all right, I got you this year. He's like, no, I got you this year. You know, kind of thing. But yeah, this is amazing. This is this guy made his stuff out of just craft foam. That's all. Even that leather is craft foam. Yeah, she said her own dress. Backstage, go and talk to people, get lots of advice, you know. Oh yeah, that's what it looks like outside. And you see, this audience is huge, okay? But you never see them when you go on stage. I mean, they're like the last thing you even notice. You don't even see them.
You can't see anything but lights.
Yeah, these guys are amazing. Okay, these guys, they come in from every year to Dragon from England. And they're the most amazing character actors you've ever seen. They are so, they just completely suck everyone's attention when they get on stage. Their costumes and their props were beautiful, but they weren't anywhere near some of the other things other folks have. Because their performance was so good, they won Best in Journeyman class. And just because of that, it's a really, really good stage actors. This guy made it amazing. This guy spent tons and tons of time in craftsmanship. I mean, this dragon is so perfect. This was the cars. I mean, it was just excellent, excellent work. And what's a lot of people fall into the trap, though, of focusing on just one aspect of cosplay. And there's so many when you're competing. Craftsmanship is very important. It's not the most important thing, though, all the time. Showmanship is very important. Making sure you're confident on stage, you're well rehearsed, you do a good performance. Making sure none of your props fall apart is very important. All these things you want to focus on. When you're making something visually stunning as well, you want to capture their attention. The components you use in your product, you want to spend a lot of attention to, like, does it do a lot of different things, you know? Or are you just a one-trick pony? You know, you want to have to be up there and, I don't know, blow fire, or blow smoke, or have light effects, or have, you know,
You don't want to get boring.
Yeah, you don't want to be boring. You don't want to just come up there and leave. You know, you want to have a thing that encompasses a lot of facets. You know, you want to be very multifaceted in your cosplay. You want to have a lot of features. Okay, so don't focus on just, I'm just going to make this cosplay look really, really good all day long on just one little thing and make it look beautiful and forget all that other stuff, because they're not judging you on one criteria. They're going to be judging you on, oh my gosh, let's see. A lot of different, and if you read the judging criteria for the cosplay competitions you go into, they'll tell you what they're going to be judging on. And so you should always check that out first too, and find out, okay, well, if they're really looking for skit-based stuff, then I might be able to do a skit with a friend, if you want to compete that way. But they'll have things like performance, craft, accuracy to your character, how accurate you are to the character, originality, are you making an original character? That's something actually as a pet peeve. Original characters, if you come up with your own thing, it is extremely hard to win with your own thing. Unfortunately, judges, they're not biased, but they do have favorites. You know, they have characters that they know and love, and if you go there with something that they can't relate to, then they have no way of judging it if it's accurate to something, or, you know, what is that? You know, I mean, look, it looks great, it's really dynamic, but I don't know what it is. And everybody else has things that they know what they are. They're going to go with some of that other stuff sometimes when it's a really close race. And so original characters are wonderful because they're so creative, but rarely do they win. Strangely enough, last year at Dragon, original character won Best in Show. I've never seen that happen. Normally, what wins Best in Show is like classic characters, things that everybody knows and loves, and they've been adored for years, you know, things like that. So the subject you choose is pretty important as well. Soundtrack, oh my god, I cannot tell you how important music is. Not only do you need to be visually stunning and dynamic on stage, but you want to have a really good soundtrack, and you want to have your performance work with the soundtrack. Like, you want to have something that builds to something, and then you have this big wow moment on stage where you do something. Your Urza Scarlet, I think, had a big wow moment. We had, like, the music playing, and then she would come out and stick out her stores and her wings pulled out really fast, and everybody just goes nuts, you know? So you want to have that on your performance. Don't do something where you just walk out and show everybody who you are and leave. Go out and do the big thing and then leave, you know? So yeah, you want to have your music. Don't just grab some EDM track off the internet and just have them play that in the background. I mean, actually sample out a section so that, like, you're building to that point and then you slam it at the same time. So you want your music and your audio and your visuals to coincide and work together.
It helps if you know, like, the poses that your character does too.
Yeah, well, that's all part of being here in character. When she takes the stage as diva, she's diva. She's up there. I mean, you forget yourself and you just become your character. I'll show you that. Like, for example, this is,
when we, this is Mechagon, with the Mecca. And this actually was a fail because they screwed up our music. But her big wow moment was getting out of the Viva, getting out of the Mecca. Everybody just kind of flipped out when they realized, oh my God, there's actually a pilot in this thing, you know? This was all, again, we practiced the hell out of this, and we scoped it all out, we talked to the theater people, we told them, hey, there's no way we're getting this on stage. You know, what do we do? So they made accommodations for us beforehand. Whereas if you just showed up with this thing, they'd be like, oh, we can't do that, we're not set up for that. And so this is kind of what you want to check, you know, you want to make sure that what you're bringing actually is feasible and capable. Everybody's kind of freaking out. It's like, what? Did you actually get out? All the poses she picked out, you know, from those all pre-rehearsed, where she was gonna, how she put her gun under her arms, that she could do that, you know, that was all rehearsed. You know, everything is pretty meticulously rehearsed. Just to go up there and have fun, man. You know, it's a blast to do. And decent night. So yeah, that's Dee. She's the MC every year. But that's pretty much most of what we've experienced. Confidence again. That's the most one of the most important things. They will see that if you just go up there. And
if you look scared, they know you're scared.
Yeah. If you're up there like, yeah, it's not going to be as important because I mean if it's just you. It would be great, but you're competing against other people that may have more experience than you, you know, that kind of thing. And so you've really got to bring it, you know, you've really got to just make sure everything's right, ready to go, and you're on target. So, do y'all have any questions for us or anything? Or as far as who else has competed? Have you competed? Or?
No.
It's a lot of fun. I still recommend it. Oh, the other thing. If you haven't competed before, by all means, compete in smaller cons first. You know, like Louisiana, this one, you know, all these kind of things, and it'll give you tons of experience and kind of shake off all the bugs, you know, beforehand. Before we compete at Dragon, we always compete at Mecca to shake out all the bugs. Like
kind of like a test run.
It's a test run, exactly. Like, okay, how are we gonna ship this thing? Are we gonna put it in a truck? Are we gonna use a lift gate? Is it gonna fit through doorways? You know, all this kind of stuff. You know, we have more problems than a lot of other cosplayers because we built a big. Compete in smaller cons first, and you're gonna lose a lot. I mean, I win every single con I ever competed in, but you learn a lot. Like I said, the biggest thing I learned is don't wing it. You know, you go up there and try to wing it last minute, and it shows. And subject matter is important. Like I said, find a nice classic character everybody likes. That'll help. It's not necessary. Yeah, we both did. It took us about 6-7 months, something like that. Yeah, it's down there. So you can come take a picture with it if you want. It was about 6 or 7 months of work. It's been pretty popular on the internet, strangely enough. I don't know why, but it kind of took off, and we've been asked to come to a couple of different conventions, so this is nice. We're actually taking it, well, theoretically, if she can get the truck. We may be taking it to Abita Springs, it's a little small convention in Abita down 8 miles that way that a friend of mine is going out. So that's the next stop. But competing's fun. It's a blast. It's a great way to plug into the cosplay community and meet people that are doing amazing things, you know, with unique materials and designs.
It's just have fun with it, because if you don't, then you won't enjoy it as much as you could be. and everyone else there is just like you, so you can make a lot of friends.
Yeah, yeah, everybody else is doing the same thing, just for the fun and love of cosplay.
That's about all we got. Anything else in here? You good? Okay. All right, well, y'all have a great day. Thank y'all so much for coming.